Hey guys, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Alexis. I'm 20 years old. I'm a young mama, and on my channel, I just make videos about me, my son, my life. So if you're interested in that type of thing, make sure to subscribe. Before I start, I want to apologize for any background noise. There's like three other people walking around the house right now, but this is as quiet as it's going to get, and this is the only place that I have to film right now, and you know, baby toys, but we're all moms here, right? So you guys can relate. But today I'm going to talk about how I sleep trained my son. He's actually asleep in his crib right now. So no crying, no nothing. So if you want to know how to do this, stick around. So a little bit of background. Before I had my son, while I was pregnant, I didn't like set any strong boundaries for myself. I wasn't like, he's never gonna sleep in bed with me, or he's only gonna sleep with me, because I know that a lot of first time moms and moms of all ages, they make comments and statements not really knowing, and I didn't want people to be like, well, you said this. So I just kept an open mind to a lot of things about parenthood. And so in the hospital when he was born, I couldn't sleep with him because they've had incidents of the babies falling out of the hospital bed onto the ground. So they've had incidents of that, so I was not allowed to sleep with him, and I had to put him right back into his bassinet during my hospital stay. I did doze off with him a little bit, but basically that just resulted in me not sleeping at all in the hospital. So once we came home, our first night home, I remember he had woke up or something, and I fed him, I changed him, and I tried to do the right thing because my family's talking in my ear, right? Like, put him in his crib. You're gonna roll over him. You're gonna smother him. He's gonna die, type of thing. So I was like, okay, you need to go in your crib. So, or his bassinet. He didn't have a crib at the time. His bassinet. So I tried to swaddle him. I was so exhausted, I couldn't even figure out the Velcro swaddle me swaddles, which are really easy if you've ever used them. I couldn't even figure that out. And I would rock him, I put him in the bassinet, and as soon as I put him down, he would start to cry. And I literally did that for like 3 or 4 hours. So I decided, screw this, we'll try again tomorrow night. So I brought him into bed with me, and we slept all night long. And after that, I was sold. I was like, no way is he going into the bassinet. I'm never trying again, and I never tried again. He's just gonna sleep with me. And so he slept with us for about 5 months of his life. And when he was about 5 months old, I just started to feel like it was time for him to be moved into his own space. So we went out about 5 or 6 months old, and we bought him a crib, and we, you know, put the crib up, and it went really well. I would allow him to fall asleep with us, and then I would put him into the crib, and he would sleep all night. He might wake up for me to pop the pacifier in, but he would sleep all night. But then it got really cold, like during the winter, it got so cold, and he would feel like an iceberg, and I felt awful. And I think he got sick, I'm not really sure. And it was just easier to keep him close to me. He was warm, he could nurse, and that was that, you know? So we started co-sleeping again. And I am a breastfeeding mom, so I did get a lot more sleep in the beginning with him breastfeeding and being in bed with us. I could just pop him on, nurse him, go right back to sleep. They woke up so much, I'd change him in the bed, throw his diaper down, take the diapers out in the morning, type of thing. In the beginning, I definitely got better sleep while co-sleeping. And so then about 8 months of age, I decided, you know what, I think it's time for him to go to his own space, to go to his own bed, because I am a full-time student, and I would have to sleep with my son or lay with my son for all of his naps. And at that point, he was taking like 3 naps a day, so, and they were all within 1 to 3 hours each, and I was like stuck in the bed with him, and I didn't mind. I loved it, but it got to the point where I was like, man, I could be doing something with this time. Like, I could be doing homework, or I could be cleaning, but I was stuck with him in the bed. It got to the point where he would cry even while I was napping with him. Like, I would try to rock him to sleep, try to boob him to sleep, and he would fuss and kick, and he couldn't get comfortable, so he was crying with or without me. And we weren't sleeping as well during the night. He was really restless. He became mobile. He was trying to crawl around. I was scared he would crawl off of the bed. I would almost have to like hold him down, not in a mean way, but like keep him still long enough for him to realize I am tired, and then go to sleep. It was horrible. It was frustrating. It was annoying. He was like half mobile, so he couldn't really get comfortable how he wanted to. And just my gut and all of that stuff put together, I was like, it's time for him to go to his bed. So I am that mom that said I would never, ever, 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 ever let my baby cry it out in any way, shape, or form. And that he was gonna sleep with us for as long as he wanted, but that didn't go to plan. So first off, I made a good sleeping area, a good sleeping room, you know, just a good sleep environment. So he had his crib, and I personally do use a pillow and a blanket and crib bumpers. Don't come after me. I was also that mom that tried to only do the blanket or the crib sheet, but he would kick his legs out, they would get stuck, he'd wake up, and he's really cuddly, so he wants to cuddle something. And so he would cuddle the pillow, and I felt safe enough for him to use a little blanket. You don't have to come after me. I know, but it works for us. So I'm sure that you do something that I would never do, and this might be something that you would never do, and we just have to agree to disagree. But he had his crib, and then we would use white noise. I just got an app on my phone. I have my iPad, so I can like bring something around with me if I need to. And I switch out whichever has less charge. I charge it up and I put the white noise on. I have the video baby monitor so I can see him. And I would make the room dark. So I would shut the blinds and shut the curtains, so it's pitch black in there. And he does use a pacifier, so he'd get his pacifier, and that was that, you know. And for bedtime, it was about the same, except he would get a bath and a book. I kind of did the Ferber method. Not exactly. There's several different ways. The most gentle is staying with your baby while your baby's in the crib, and you just pat your baby. You don't take your baby out the crib. You just pat your baby, love on your baby till they go to sleep. The gentle way is to leave the baby in the crib and then say sit in a rocker and just like watch your baby. But I couldn't have my baby sitting there screaming at me, like looking at me. I would feel evil. Then there's less gentle, which is what I did, which is controlled crying. And then there's not gentle at all, which is completely crying it out, which I could never ever do. So I got him ready, made the room dark, put the white noise on, and I started with nap time, actually. I just decided to start one day. We started with nap time, and I put him in the crib. And with the Ferber method, you put the baby in the crib, you leave, and you do 2 minutes the first time, 5 minutes the second time. The next day, it might increase to 10 minutes, 15 minutes. I could not let my kid cry for like maybe 10 minutes, but 15, 20 minutes, no way. So I didn't do that exactly. And with the Ferber method, you don't go in. Well, you do go in, but when you go in, you don't pick your baby up. You just like show your baby like, hey, I'm still here, and then you leave. But I would leave the room, I had the baby video monitor, and he would start to cry, and I'd set the timer for 5 minutes. And if he wasn't done crying by the end of the 5 minutes, I would go into the room, I would pick him up, I would rock him, sing to him, nurse him, whatever I felt was necessary. Sometimes I wouldn't, sometimes I would just pick him up, lay him back down, sometimes I'd have to stay and pat him, but you know your baby, so I would just kind of follow his cries, follow his cues, and do what I thought would work for that moment. And then I would leave again and do 5 minutes again. And there was only a handful of times where I had to go in a third time. So most of the time, he only ever cried 10 minutes broken up into 5 minute segments. That makes sense. He'd cry for 5 minutes, then he'd cry for another 5 minutes. And then he was out and he slept. The first day was horrible. I was literally crying and I felt guilty and I thought he would hate me and never love me again. And the first week, it was better. By the second week, I gave myself 1 week, because after the first day, I didn't even want to do it. His dad didn't even want to do it, and I was like, I'm gonna stick it out for 1 week and see how this goes. So after 1 week, it was better enough for me to continue. And after 2 weeks, we were basically almost there. So he started going down for his first nap and bedtime really easy. It was that second nap. If I look occupied, it's because my dog's here. The second nap, sometimes we'd have to skip, and honestly, you should give it about an hour. So there's the crib hour. If you try to put your baby down at 2 p.m., you want to continue to go in and do controlled crying until 3 p.m., but I never did it past 30 minutes. I just couldn't. I would break and just take him out. So we would skip the second nap a lot, but slowly and slowly he was doing really well for both his naps during the day. At this point he was taking two naps and bedtime. But then we ran into the issue where bedtime he would cry and I couldn't understand why. So what I started to do is before bedtime, after we did, you know, bath time, dark room, white noise, book, while we're in the dark with the white noise, before I put him down, I would sing You Are My Little Sunshine like 6 times. And I would just sing to him and pat him, and it's really cute because he would pat me back and it gets him sleepy just enough where he's really calm, and I would lay him down and he wouldn't cry for bedtime anymore. So you do run into hurdles. Sometimes you do have to retrain them in a way because they do have sleep regressions around certain months of their lives, and you could look that up, that's a whole different thing. But they do have sleep regressions, so sometimes you'll have to redo it. They'll be really great for a while and then they're not, and you don't know why, and it's probably a sleep regression. Usually it passes, but if it doesn't, you might have to retrain them. I know people hate that because they're not a dog, but you are teaching them how to go to sleep on their own and that it's okay, and it definitely is a gift. It's a gift to sleep that they'll carry on the rest of their lives. My son slept through the night as an infant, but by the time we started sleep training around 8 months, he wasn't sleeping through the night anymore. That's one of the other reasons I decided to sleep train him. And within like 2 or 3 nights, he was sleeping through the night. He was waking up 3 times a night, like a newborn. And within a couple of days, he started sleeping through the night. But after about, I don't know, a few weeks, he started waking up through the night again. And I remember at his 9 month appointment, I remember writing down to his doctor that he was sleeping 10 or more hours straight through the night. But that didn't last very long because he started to wake up again. He currently just turned 1 year old and I just got him to sleep through the night again. So I didn't want to make this video until he was sleeping through the night again and everything was like great, you know. So he is finally sleeping through the night again, and the reason why he started waking up is, one, I think he had a sleep regression. And it's just so easy. If he would wake up just once a night, and if it was later in the morning, like 4 a.m. or whatever, I would just bring him to bed with me. And I got in the habit of, every time he would wake up, I would just bring him to bed with me and pop him on the boob. So he got in the habit of waking up and wanting breast. And he's at the age where he doesn't need breast milk during the night. He doesn't need the night feeds. And he started waking up more and more and more and more and more. So I just had to be stern. It's so hard to do it at night, especially with a partner, because my husband has to work, and I felt bad letting the baby cry in the night, and like he would almost go and get him, and I'm like, no, just leave him alone. So I decided just to buckle down and to do it in the night also, because it's hard, it's not easy. So the first time I sleep trained him, I didn't really do it during the night. I just like laid him back down and gave him the pacifier, and he didn't put up much fight, but he was really fighting me. I tried taking him out and nursing him and putting him back. I tried taking him out and leaving him in the bed with us. I tried taking him out and just rocking him. It wasn't working. So he cried. I would get out of the bed and I would give him his pacifier if that's what he wanted. And I would lay him down and, you know, night-night. It's night-night time and he knows that word. And I put 5 minutes. It took 5 minutes and he cried and he fussed and he cried. And then I went back over there, and it sucks because his bed's right by us, so he's like staring at me and I can see him through the dark trying to find me. So then I went back over there and I laid him down again and I put 5 minutes on again. And then after that 5 minutes, he went to sleep. And I wanna say it took like only two nights of doing this, and he's been sleeping through the night. He goes down for bed at about 8 p.m. and he doesn't even wake up for his pacifier if it falls out his mouth. And he'll stay in bed from 8 till about 5 a.m. when his dad wakes up. We do share a room. So he hears his dad and he wakes up, which isn't that big of a deal. Like, I'll take it. That's like 9 hours asleep. I think he would stay asleep, but I think he's used to waking up at 5 a.m. and also his dad wakes him up. So if he wakes up while his dad's getting ready for work, I just bring him to bed with me, and then he'll sleep with me from about 5 a.m. to like lately. He's been sleeping a long time. It's been like 8:30, 9, 10. And the first time I sleep trained him, he would wake up at like 7:30 or 8, like on the dot. but he's been sleeping a lot longer lately. It's really amazing to be able to just go into the room and lay him down and him go to sleep all on his own. I like had to have the time for me, and I napped with him for so long that I don't feel like I'm missing out on like cuddles or anything. And I will definitely do this for all of my future babies. You can have cheat naps. Like, as long as your baby's having at least one nap a day in their crib, you should be okay. I hold my son for naps usually on Tuesdays and Thursdays when I'm babysitting at somebody else's house, and it doesn't mess him up at all. But I hope that you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Turn on your post notifications, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!